The topic of my presentation is non-classical particles and their application for modeling media with non-mechanical properties. Вот.
This is for the
for next.
The yellow one. Yeah, next. There's no next. You will have to do it from.
Ah. Thank you. The opinion that the classical mechanics is not applicable in microcosm is well known. But the question is what kind of classical mechanics? The answer is obvious. The Newtonian mechanics, I mean the mechanics of mass point, is not applicable in microcosm. However, the classical mechanics now the classical mechanics is not only the mechanics of mass points. Now the fundamental laws of mechanics that are more general than second law by Newton are formulated. I mean the earlier mechanics laws. And in the framework of classical mechanics, there are many more complicated models than mass point. I mean the such particles as rigid bodies, as systems of rigid body, I mean the multi-spin particles, and the particles having the non-classical properties. These particles I will be discussed in my presentation. I am sure that we consider the classical mechanics as a method for description of some physical processes, and if we use the more complicated models than mass points and rigid bodies, we can try to describe some physical processes and phenomena which now consider as coming out from the classical mechanics. For example, I'm sure that if we try to use the body points of a general type, we can be successful. The body point of a general point is defined as particles having their kinetic energy, as you can see here. The important properties of these particles is that this particle can be essentially different from the infinitesimal rigid body. I mean that the cross term in this expression can be different from the analogous term in the kinetic energy for a rigid body. If we consider a rigid body, we have antisymmetric tensor B. We can consider the particle which have an arbitrary tensor B. And the particle such a kind will be discussed further. The momentum and proper angular momentum of the body point is defined as the partial derivative with respect to translational velocity and the angular velocity correspondingly. And the angular momentum of body point calculated with respect to some fixed point Q is calculated by this formula. The basic laws of Eulerian mechanics are represented here. These are the equation of momentum balance, the equation of angular momentum balance, and the equation of energy balance. Here, external forces, external moments, and the terms which characterize the supply of momentum and angular momentum into the system. This equation are formulated for arbitrary body. Now let us consider a simple example which shows the system consisting of frame and internal particles. The aim of this consideration is to derive the approximate equations and for the motion of frame, and to show that this equation will be the same as the equation of motion of the particle such a kind. Now they consider equation of motion of the frame, equations of motion of internal bodies. The frame and internal bodies can move along the axis x and rotate about this axis. This is the force and moments which characterizes the interaction between the frame and internal bodies, and after simple transformations and the averaging near over a period of motion of the internal bodies, we can derive the following equations. Here you can see equation in the case of the external force and moment being the linear function of time. And here you can see the second example when the external force and moment are the periodic function, but the period of this function are much less, much more than the period of motion of internal bodies. You can see Here the new parameters in these approximate equations, which can be calculated by these formulas. It is easy to see that these are equations of motion, and on the right hand of these equations we see the derivative of momentum and the derivative of the proper angular momentum. So we can consider these equations as the equations of motion of the particle, which is not a mass point, but which is the particle such of kind. Now let us consider the dynamical properties of the particle. First of all, I show a simplest example. The problem of free motion of the body point having such kinetic energy, and the equation of free motion of this body point are here. This problem can be solved analytically, and it is easy to show that the trajectory of this particle will be a helical line, as on this picture, and the translational the magnitude of translational velocity will be constant. Now let us consider more complicated problem. I mean the problem of the motion of the body point near a center of attraction. I mean, for example, the motion under the extra gravity force or Coulomb force. The equations of the motion you can see here. This is equation of momentum balance, and this is equation of the angular momentum balance. K is constant and A is constant. It is proved that the trajectory of this particle is a space curve, and the proper the magnitude of the proper angular momentum is constant. Now we consider the particular case of the problem. To be exact, I mean the case when the magnitude of momentum is constant. The initial conditions should be such that these equations are satisfied, and in the case their problem is reduced to the equation with respect to magnitude of radius vector of the particle. This this equation has the constant coefficients, but this equation is a nonlinear equation, and if we find this function, then other quantities can be found by integrating of known function and solving the algebraic equations. Let us consider the results. In the case when the magnitude of momentum is constant, the following facts are proved. First of all, if this condition is satisfied, then the trajectory will be a space curve. And the magnitude of radius vector is satisfied this inequality. So the numerical results show that the trajectory of the particle cuts the space between two spheres. One sphere has radius R1 and another sphere has radius R2. So this is analogous to the situation when we consider the motion of electron around the positive charge. It is known that the trajectory of this particle is not a circle, is not a plane trajectory, but the negative charge is placed between such two spheres. And another result is the projection of the proper angular momentum on the constant vector k is a constant approximately. And this quantity can be treated as a spin of particle, for example, as spin of electron if we model the electron by the body point of general type. So, if we consider body points of a general time as a basic object for modeling a continuous medium, I mean the medium which are the electronic gas or gas of some virtual particles, for example, phonon gas, then we confronted with the following problem. If we consider the medium to be isotropic medium in the conventional sense, then we see that the according to the theory of symmetry, parameter B must be equal to zero. The solution of the problem can be following. We can consider this medium as a chiral isotropic medium. The symmetry group of a chiral isotropic medium contains only the rotation tensors, but it does not include any mirror reflection tensors. Here you can see some formulas of the theory of symmetry. And using this definition and using the Curie-Neyman principle, we can construct the structure of the tensors of different rank. For example, if we consider a chiral isotropic medium, then the fourth rank tensor have the such form, and the second rank tensor is spherical part of tensor. If we consider an isotropic medium in the classical sense, then the polar tensors have the same structure, but the axial tensors are equal to zero. That is why I think that we should consider the medium consistent of this particle as a chiral isotropic medium. For example, suppose that particles simulate atoms. Properties of continuum consistent of such particles in the integral sense reflect the properties of these particles. Therefore, if we consider the chiral particles, then the medium consisting of such particles should be chiral too. The atoms consist of elementary particles which have the spins. They are the heterotropic particles, and therefore I think that the medium consisting of elementary particles or atoms which are constructed by the elementary particles can be considered as a chiral medium. Now I will discuss the particle with microstructure. We can consider two-spin particles or multi-spin particles consisting of the classical particles or of a body point of a general type. For example, two-spin particle, you can see here. Two-spin particle consists of the carrier body and the rotor. And the rotor can rotate independently of rotation of the carrier body, but it cannot move with respect to the carrier body. And now You can see here the control volume of the continuum of two spin particles, and I think that continuum of such a kind can be used to model media with various physical properties which provided by the gas of virtual particle like the phonons or real particle like the electrons. I mean the thermoconductivity or electroconductivity processes in the material can be described by using the multi-component media, one component of which is the classical media, and it describe and it models the mechanical properties of the material, and other components are non-classical particles, and they used in order to model the some properties which is not mechanical properties. So, yes. Two types of particles exist. They are particles which can deform, and they are particles which have internal rotational degrees of freedom. And two types of media exist. The micromorphic media, which consist of deformable particles, and the micropolar media, which consist of multi-spin particles. In principle, both deformable particle and multi-spin particle can be used to model atoms. But some arguments in favor of micropolar continua. Suppose that we consider atom as a deformable particle. And in the case of large strains, we have a problem associated with keeping the atom as a whole and holding their characteristic sizes. If we consider atom as a complicated particle with internal rotational degrees of freedom, then we doesn't have such problems. In view of the fact that all physical processes certain conditions should be described by the nonlinear theory, then I think that the particles with internal rotational degrees of freedom are more suitable for the purpose of the modeling atoms and other elementary particles. Thanks for attention.
Yes. And when I was a student, Maradona came to Napoli, and the professor of theoretical physics came to us, and we spoke, say, 3 days about why, when Maradona was beating the stumbling ball, the trajectory was not clean. And why? the ball was doing strange effects. I think that this model will never marry me.
Football was a non-classical football.
Yeah.
I mean the particle consistent, which consists of two particles, which can rotate independently each other, but which cannot move independently. I mean the translational movement. I mean the particles like the gyrostats.
I cannot see how you can model non-mechanical properties with a microscopic model, which is mechanical. So you show that those internal degrees of freedom are still mechanical.
If I have the additional degrees of freedom, then I have additional parameters and I have additional differential equation. If the differential equation have the same structure as the equation of thermoconductivity or equation of electroconductivity or Maxwell equation or some other equation, I mean the mathematical form, then I can treat the this component as a mechanical model of the physical processes, and I can treat the parameters of the additional component as analogous of physical quantities characterizing the such physical properties as thermoconductivity, for example, or electroconductivity, for example, or some other properties. I mean the mechanical analogous of physical processes. I'm not sure that these models can explain the physical meaning of the some processes, but I am sure that we can use the model in order to obtain the non-linear equations, for example, in the case when we have only linear equations. For example, Maxwell equations are linear equations, but if we want to consider analogous processes in the non-linear area, then the mechanical model can be useful.
I think he's convinced. So this is last quick question.
Yes, it's a short question. If you project the angular moment, you have several costs there. But what is the value? I mean, if it has to be an electron in a way, there must be a transverse. There must be some numerical values on the world.
Uh, I mean that it is known that electrons have constant spin. And in framework of my model, I obtain some quantity, namely the projection of the proper angular momentum on some constant vector, and I show that this quantity is constant, but only approximate.
All right, thank you.